Tale recapped plus here. No one knew what he was up to. He can be seen working in a warehouse where he breaks a number plate on purpose and dumps it in a dust bin, declaring that it's been damaged. I'm going to explain episodes 1 and 2 of the movie called The Breakout Kings. August Tillman, a prisoner, is practicing how to hold himself under the bed at the beginning of the show. Not long after that, he breaks a license plate on purpose, throws it in the trash, and says that it's broken. This picture shows that he has already done the same trick with many number plates in the trash. For some reason, he leaves the building one day to get rid of the broken license plates that are in the warehouse. He hides under a police bus with the help of the number plates that he has gathered to hold himself up, while a pretty girl keeps the guards busy. The guards don't see him, though, so they let the bus leave the building. After a short time, Tillman comes out of hiding and strikes the driver and a woman in the passenger seat. From there, the scene changes to Ray Zaccanelli, a former U.S. Marshal who lost his job after being found guilty of stealing money from a crime scene. Charlie Duchamp, who is now a deputy U.S. Marshal, approaches him outside of a halfway house and asks for his help in his new plan to put Tillman back in jail. When they got to the police station later, Charlie suggested that Ray pick some inmates from a list and work with them to find escape artists. In order to solve the case and find Tillman, they want to hire real escape artists. Now we meet four escape artists from different U.S. jails in the next scene. Gunnarsson is a fighter. She Daniels used to traffic weapons. Philomena, also known as Philly, is a bounty hunter and skilled tracker. And Dr. Lloyd Lowry used to be a child genius and behaviorist. They meet up with Ray and Charlie, who tell them about the task. Charlie tells them that their sentences will be cut short, and they will be sent to a minimum security jail if they help them catch Tillman. When the escape artists hear this, they get excited and accept the offer right away. After that, Charlie tells the group what their goal is and promises to give each of them a cell phone while they are on duty. While that was going on, Julian Sims, a research assistant for the mission, showed up and told Charlie that John Phelps, one of Tillman's childhood friends, had been found dead from being beaten. The team goes right to the scene of the crime and starts working right away. Lloyd looks around because he is a behaviorist and tells the police that Tillman is trying to trick them by writing the name of a Mexican city on the fridge. In this picture, a cell phone is hidden under a table, and Tillman is listening in on the officer's talk with it. The next scene shows Sims calling Ray to tell him about a bank heist that happened a year ago, before Tillman was caught. Soon, while the team is having lunch at a restaurant, she starts to gather more about the case. During this time, Charlie finds Gunnarsson hiding as he ties his hands and puts a knife down his socks before going to find Jimbo, another friend of Tillman's. On the other hand, Tillman is already in Jimbo's house, forcing him to tell him about the money they stole a year ago. Jimbo is hit with a hammer and killed when he doesn't answer. When the police arrived a short time later, they found Jimbo dead on a chair. Ray also sees a cell phone under a table and tells Tillman that he will soon be caught. Later, the police go to the home of Carmen Menhofer, the cashier who was at the Shirley Bank when it was robbed. Carmen's boyfriend tries to talk to the police while she drives away from the house because he thinks they are in danger. Charlie asks Shay to follow her, which works out well because he stops her on the way. Lloyd talks to Carmen during the questioning when she says she didn't help Tillman rob the bank. Based on his knowledge, he decides that she is not guilty. At that very moment, Erica and Sims learn that Kyle Taro, the teller, is actually the one who stole the money. She also says that Kyle quit his job a week ago and hasn't been in touch since. Tillman can also be seen making threats against Kyle's wife and daughter at his house. Next, we see that Kyle's whole team is waiting for him to move, but they can't find any. Philly advises that the police take her shopping and asks them to help her deal with Kyle's brother Frank, who is helping Kyle with his money. Soon after, Philly and Lloyd walk into Frank's bar pretending to be a couple. While they're there, Philly keeps staring at Frank in an attempt to seduce him. Frank takes her to a room after the bar closes and Philly starts stripping for him. She steals Frank's cell phone when he's not looking and says she'll be right back before leaving the room. As soon as she steps outside, she starts looking for Kyle's number on his phone. But Frank walks in and stops Philly in her tracks. He grabs her by the throat and says he will tell everyone who she is. Lloyd gets to send Charlie a text message while all of this is going on to let him know what's going on. Charlie, Ray, and Shay quickly sneak into the bar and grab Frank. During the arrest, Ray shoots Frank to scare him. Because of this, Charlie gets mad and tells Ray to do what he says since he is in charge of the job. The team gets Kyle's address from Frank and goes to his house, where they find his wife tied to a chair in the next scene. When Charlie frees her, she tells him that Tillman has taken her daughter and Kyle. Later, she also tells Charlie what Kyle looks like on the face to help him find a picture of him. Here, they find out that Tillman has had help from a pretty girl named Amy Flynn the whole time. When Ray sees that Tillman is driving with Amy toward Canada, he suggests that they get to the border before Amy does and catch Tillman. After some time, the whole group can be seen at the border between the US and Canada, where Amy and Tillman stop at a gas station to fill up their car. Philly and Shay follow them and get Tillman out of the car after he swears at Amy. Shay tries to get Kyle's daughter out of the car but finds that she has a bomb on her, and Tillman's cell phone is in charge of it. Charlie shows up just in time to stop Ray from approaching Tillman and threatening to shoot him. Charlie shoots Tillman in the shoulder while he is putting down Ray and trying to get away. Lloyd is seen talking to his daughter inside a minimum security jail in the last scene of the show. Philly is on the computer checking her bank balance, and Shay is looking at a picture of his girlfriend and counting down the days until he can leave jail. At the end of the show, Ray tells Charlie that he stole the money from the crime scene to buy his daughter a car. The second episode starts at Clayton Penitentiary, where everyone is getting ready for Xavier Price's execution in a few days. Price is a mass killer. Xavier gets some tools, like a bed sheet and a box of paper clips, before he is put to death. While the jail was double-checking the electricity around the building on Xavier's day of execution, he used the paper clips to make a spark that set fire to his cell. He also breaks out in flames and cries out for help. When they take him to the jail hospital, he attacks the doctor and then gets out of the building through a small hole. Xavier uses the bedsheet to make a banner that makes him look like a protester. He then uses an underground tunnel to get outside the jail. When a female protester outside sees him and knows he is Xavier, he holds her down and takes her car. This scene then moves to the police station, where Lloyd and Shay are brought back from jail to look for Xavier. This is where they find out that Philly stole money from a prison computer and is sent back to the prison where she started her term with a 2-year bonus. They also see Erica Reed, who is filling in for Philly, and are curious about what special skill she has. Charlie gets Erica to sign the forms and adds her to their team. Soon, someone will tell the team about Xavier's crimes and how he got out of jail. So Erica suggests that they talk to Xavier's wife to find out more about him since the information they have is still not clear. Xavier goes to one of his homes and sets it on fire somewhere else. Everyone on the team meets Xavier's wife in the next scene. She tells him that her husband is a good person. Sims then calls Ray and tells him about the house Xavier bought at auction a year ago and put under his name. As soon as the team gets to the house, they are shocked to see that it has been completely destroyed by fire. In spite of this, the forensics team still finds a box of melted plastic. This scene then changes to Xavier digging in the ground while a little girl sits next to him. The girl begs him to let her go, but Xavier is so mean that he grabs her by the hair and kills her. When the group gets to a store, the owner tells them that Xavier struck him after changing the price tag on an axe. She thinks that Xavier might be buying the tool to break into something instead of killing someone right away. At the same time, Sims calls Ray and tells him about a house that Xavier just bought that is near a quiet area. When Ray and Charlie get there right away, they find a girl trapped in the basement of the house. No matter how hard they try to question the girl, she won't give them any answers. Just as the police leave, the girl suddenly speaks up and tells Erica that Xavier has trapped more girls like her. When the team gets back to the office, they gather information and learn that the other people are dead. Two girls, one was burned to death and the other was buried. In the end, they decide that Xavier likes to hurt girls and exercise power over them. Then Lloyd uses his skills to learn that Xavier's mother, who was a prostitute, abused him as a child. She also often left him in shelters, which is why he hates prostitutes and wants to kill them by torturing them. After the news comes out, Charlie asks Sim to give him information about the women who have been missing near Xavier's house for a year. After a while, Sims gives Charlie the list of women who haven't been seen in 6 months. Seeing this, Lloyd mentions that Xavier is holding something personal from the girls he tortured to keep himself occupied until he finds another. It is his suggestion that they get a search warrant and search Xavier's house. Later, Ray, Charlie, and Lloyd arrive at Xavier's home and start searching around, despite his wife refusing them from doing so. After a while, Lloyd takes a closer look at Xavier's art collections and finds a broken molar tooth of a woman. Next, they find a woman's fingernail and also a single strand of hair. Ray suggests they run a DNA test on the hair to find the location of the missing third girl. In the next scene, while the team is trying to find the third girl, they get a video message from the forensics, which includes Xavier torturing a woman. Because the video is so dark, the officers are unable to recognize the woman. In the meantime, Ray hears a train in the video's background and concludes that the building where Xavier is holding the girl is near a train track. Sims then does some research and comes up with a list of 8 houses around the train tracks near Xavier's properties. Meanwhile, when Lloyd approaches Erica and inquires if she lost her child recently, she gets enraged and starts punching him. Because she committed violence during the work, Charlie handcuffs her in the office and sets out to inspect the buildings without her. In the following scene, Charlie and Ray check each of the buildings but are unable to find any girl inside. Hearing Sims and Ray talk about this, Erica realizes that Ray and Charlie are in the wrong town. She then reveals that the sound Ray heard in the video's background is not of a train, but of an industrial whistle from a refinery in Sloan. With this, Sims narrows down her search and identifies the girl who has gone missing from Sloan, Andrea. Following the information from Erica, the team arrives at the house where Xavier is torturing Andrea. While Xavier sets fire to the house and is about to take Andrea out, Ray and Charlie confront him, causing him to rush back into the house. He leaves Andrea on the floor and runs upstairs into the burning house. Charlie gets Andrea out of the house while Ray follows Xavier. Finally, with no way out, Xavier is forced to jump out of a window, trying to get away. Fortunately, Shay, who's waiting outside, catches him and promises him that he will live the rest of his life in solitary prison, suffering the tortures that he inflicted on innocent girls. In the last scene of the show, Charlie explains to Ray about Erica's past and how she tracked down the murders of her father and killed them without getting caught. After knowing everything about Erica, Ray sees her and suggests she control her anger if she wants to be on the team and reduce her sentence. The show ends with Erica agreeing to comply with the team and work with full control over her anger. That was all from the movie. I hope you liked it. Subscribe for more videos like this, turn on notifications, and leave a like to help.